Tom Kiffin.
And welcome back to Local 3 News at 11. I'm meteorologist Tom Kiffin. You do see the green here on some of the parts of the radar, but this isn't reaching the ground, just the radars across the Upper Great Lakes National Weather Service radars are just in a real sensitive mode and a slower mode tonight. And when we do have quieter weather like we do tonight, we don't really have to overuse the radars. And as you can see, we do have clear skies across the UP, and that's going to continue as we head through the rest of the night. As you can see on our radar and satellite, as we widen out the view, you can see we do have rain showers back across the northern plains, and then we do have some rain back across Iowa, Illinois, and Missouri. And that's a storm system that might affect a little bit of far southern lower Michigan this weekend. But as you can see, it's going to remain well south of the UP. As I put this into motion here, this is going to move through Indiana, Ohio, and then parts of lower Michigan. But with the center of the low pressure with this storm system moving across Kentucky and Tennessee, we're actually going to get a counterclockwise flow around that low. And that's going to send a northeasterly wind right over Lake Superior. So that means it's going to be chilly right along Lake Superior this weekend. The storm system moves off to the east. We remain dry all weekend, but our rain chances, I think, start to increase on Monday out ahead of our next storm system that will be moving through the Canadian prairies and northern plains on Sunday night. So sunshine this weekend is what's ahead, along with milder temperatures for inland areas both Saturday and also Sunday. But as we head into next week, our rain chances increase and wind will be possible, along with much cooler temperatures by the time we get to the middle of next week. High temperatures today. Look at the Wisconsin-Michigan border areas. Temperatures into the 60s. Elsewhere, we had temperatures in the 50s, but closer to the shorelines of the Great Lakes, we had temperatures in the 40s. Even downtown Marquette at the U.S. Coast Guard, we had a high temperature today of only 37 degrees. 29 was the low, and officially at the National Weather Service in Nagani Township, we had a high today of 50, a low of 21. A little bit shy of the record low of 18 just set back 5 years ago on this date. Current temperatures are in the 30s, but Iron Mountain still hanging on to 40 degrees and Ironwood still hanging on to 41. And as we look at our forecast for tonight, mainly clear skies. Look for low temperatures tonight in the 30s, but some inland areas may fall into the 20s. Here's your extended forecast. Marquette County temperatures both Saturday and Sunday will range from the 30s along Lake Superior to 50s well inland. And that's going to be the same for the eastern UP. Temperatures in the 40s, 50s well inland towards Germanfast and also Seney. And then we'll start getting some rain in here as we go into Monday and Tuesday. For Marquette County in the eastern UP, on Monday and Tuesday, the winds are going to turn southerly, and that's going to mean an offshore wind. And that means most, if not all, locations between Marquette and also Munising and Grand Marais should be milder. For the south central UP, it's an offshore wind this weekend. High temperatures both days around 50 or the 50s, but the wind becomes onshore out of the south on Monday and Tuesday, and that's going to mean chillier conditions along Lake Michigan and the Bay of Green Bay. But we'll still have 50s well inland. For the interior west, 50s through the weekend and early next week. And then for the Keweenaw Peninsula, once again, high temperatures 30s near Lake Superior, 50s to around 60 well inland for the Keweenaw Peninsula and also for the interior west. Everybody's rain chances, I think, start to increase Monday on into Tuesday and Wednesday. And then I think everybody's going to be turning chillier for Tuesday night on into Wednesday, along with increasing wind. And I wouldn't be surprised at night if we may see some snow mixing in some parts of Upper Michigan Tuesday night and also Wednesday night. James, back to you.